previously, robots have sort of been in cages in manufacturing areas. Cobalt's idea is to create a robot that is perceived as a friendly office robot.
The Cobalt robot, as a security or office application, it has two really key elements to it.
On the bottom half of the robot, it's basically a self-driving car. So we have LiDAR, depth cameras, and lots of navigation sensors so that the robot can find its way around a building and not bump into anything.
It is primarily an autonomous vehicle. It maps the inside of an office, interior of a warehouse, or whatever space needs to be patrolled.
Detecting any anomalies, like a person, motion, sound, anything like that out of the ordinary. Kind of works with the building security to tackle anything unusual, like trespassers.
And when it finds something that is abnormal, a person, motion, a door being open, a leak or a spill, a sound that shouldn't be there, it alerts a human being to remote in and manage that event.
The specialist does a bunch of things both from a security perspective, from a human interaction perspective, but also even a robot perspective. Robots encounter weird events, things they may never have seen. Sort of a combination of all of these capabilities, it's really core to the human in the loop technology that we develop.
Hi there, how's it going?
Good, how about yourself?
Doing well, thank you. Do you mind badging in for me, please?
Sure.
The design of the robot itself also lends itself to being perceived as friendly and non-threatening.
Having the screen on it, having this fabric and this curve, all of these little elements are helping make this a warm experience.
The other part of it is the artificial intelligence and machine learning software. And I think the AI and machine learning software is the area that is really going to expand and change, not just at Cobalt, but in our lifetimes as we go forward.
Robots represent computers that can literally reach out and touch the world. The applications are going to be profound in ways we can't possibly imagine, and this is the most compelling entry point to really develop those early systems.